it's got to be orange sherbet. I don't know, I always liked it as a kid, and it might not be the manliest thing, but I enjoy it. It's hot outside, can't get your hands on a freezy, gotta get yourself some orange sherbet. No, I always just remember my brother, he always liked it, so I had to do everything that my brother wanted, so obviously I had to have the orange sherbet. yeah, I'm more of a candy guy, you know, gummy bears, gummy worms, yeah, just simple stuff like that. You can't really put gummy bears on anything and it'd be bad. Cup. I think it's just when it drips, you know, I like to take my time with my ice cream. I don't want to be pressured under the heat of the gun. I'm not here for the cone, I'm here for the ice cream. My dad always played with me when we were growing up, and so, you know, obviously I wanted to be like my dad, and then my brother obviously started, and it started off on rollerblades, and, you know, once I was into the rollerblades, then we got on the ice, and originally, I just remember this one time when we were younger, I went on the ice and my feet hurt so bad, and I wasn't having it, and then the next day I went back out, and it was the same kind of story, but, you know, you stuck with it, and, you know, obviously here we are today. it's good. Obviously, when you're in your first year or in your first couple years there, you're not quite sure about, you know, living and the rough and tough schedule. Obviously, coming from junior, you're kind of simulated with a pro schedule, but, you know, you're not on your own away from the rink. And, you know, being in your third year, you know, you're a lot more comfortable with your surroundings and, you know, the everyday life. And, you know, you can get into a groove quicker rather than, you know, taking a little more time to adjust, I think. You know, more or less in minor hockey, you get bounced around with pairings, but in pro hockey especially, I think, you know, to be with Devon and to be with a player like that and, you know, just have that familiarity, it's key. You know, I think every game that we go into, we know what we're going to get from each other. You know, you can read off each other that easy, and, you know, it's great. It's familiarity off the ice too, obviously. Like, we live 20 minutes away from each other in the summer, work out together in the summer, and, you know, we carpool into the gym every day together, so, you know, we see a lot of each other, and you know, it's great. I've enjoyed it these past few years. It's actually funny, he just lives down the street from me here too, so we see him a lot when I'm walking my dog and other things like that. So it's the dream, that's the goal. Obviously, you know, you grew up obviously idolizing guys that, you know, you watch playing in every night on the TV. You know, you watch Hockey Night in Canada, you know, you watch all these guys that came before you and the honor they have, and, you know, obviously you worked your whole life for it, and you know, it'd mean a lot, obviously, and you know, you just gotta take it day by day and, you know, keep working, and, you know, hopefully it pays off. It'd be my mom and my dad. Yeah, easy one for me. I'd probably call my dad first, just because, yeah, mom would be conferenced in by my dad, I'm sure. Yeah, I'd probably have to call my dad first, just because, you know, he's there. He's kind of like my ear when if I need anything to talk to about hockey and stuff like that. So it's nice. Just have fun. Keep working. I think you know, you're gonna grow up. It's not always if you have early success. You know, you got to keep pushing, keep having fun, and, you know, take the experiences and the friends that you make there. And, you know, obviously you're gonna grow up with those guys, and, you know, continue to have fun and work hard.